Hey, this is Andrew bringing you another Dark Tidings deck reveal and review. Oop, that is a house right there. I saw a yellow. That portends shadows, I suppose. Hero Lords Ziphunt, or Zip Hunt. I'm going to look for Sanctum and Star Alliance and Shadows. Oh, wow. That was actually Sarian, Unfathomable Star Alliance. Hey, cool. That's cool. I like this. 1 second while I enter the code. All right, so in Unfathomable, I'm hoping to be able to disrupt the opponent a lot. Really keep them off their game, maybe slow down their deck. In Star Alliance, I'm hoping for the opposite for me to be able to speed up and get everything I want done faster. And in Sarian, I'm hoping for board and amber control. Maybe some snazzy combos, you never know. We'll be starting with Sarian here. All right. Oh, sorry about that. You destroy a creature and its controller gains one. Yep. Ooh, Gladiodontus. Big creature. It enters play stunned. It only deals five when it's fighting, but that's enough to kill most things. And typically you'll get to use it twice per turn, but the second use has to be a fight. Humble, great way to get rid of some amber. Or if you don't have any amber on your creatures, just exhaust an enemy creature. That's not bad. Physicus Felix lets us exalt a creature. That's cool. Wipe clear is good for popping wards or dealing with small creatures, and it also gets rid of upgrades. That'll be interesting to see how that fits in with our Star Alliance here. Altruis Rostrum lets us move amber around. That could be nice. Cornice and Octavia gives us a little capture, slow capture. Decadence lets us either exalt, ready, and use a friendly creature or move amber from a creature to another creature. That's pretty cool. And yeah, there's some good stuff we might want to use there, like get the Gladiodontus in action faster. Ooh, we got a second Decadence. Cool. Medicus Lacus. Yeah, very nice. If we get amber on our creatures, I think we're going to be kind of constantly, it looks like we're going to be constantly dealing with one or two amber on our creatures, not a ton. So I'm not going to expect the Lacus to be super important, but sometimes that means people will let it sneak by, right? If you're only spending one or two, is it worth raising the tide? People struggle with that. Two Lacus is great. That means more likely to have one on the table at any time. Got a Venator Altum, very nice creature. It's just big. If the tide is low and it takes damage, then it gets exalted. That could be bad, but it is such a big body. It's nice to have around. All right, let's see what we get in Star Alliance. Colonus Chapman, that's nice. If you get him protecting creatures, maybe get him protecting the Lacuses. People aren't that eager to get to them, but now they have Reap gain one. That's pretty good. Selective Preservation. Choose a creature of each power value. Destroy each creature not chosen. We have a pretty good spread right now. 3, 5, 7, more 5s than 15. A Static Collection Array. I have mixed feelings about this. I think n maybe nice in a deck with a lot of tide control effects because we can afford to keep pulling the tide back over to our side and giving us a minus 1 forge cost. While the opponent is, spending chains, but just a little iffy because the opponent ultimately can use it to punish us a little. Stunner, great. It's always great to have a stunner. Get that stun in when you fight a Reap. Xeno Training, a little bit of extra capture there. Hey, that's nice. That fits well with, the Medicus Lacus and some of the other stuff, the Rostrum. Ambervac, sure. Yeah, it raises the tide and can potentially capture if the creature it's on stays alive. CR Officer Hawkins can gain us some amber when it's played. That's nice. Grand Alliance Council, another great board wipe. It was really good. Operative Espeon, always interesting this one, because so the effect is after a player raises the tide during their turn, they may use a creature they control. And just because it's two-sided, it's a little dangerous, right? Your opponent may have a way to get more value out of it than you, although you can see what's on their board and probably decide based on that because, it's only going to matter for things that are already on the board when they start their turn, mostly because that's what's going to be ready. So it doesn't say ready and use, it just says use. So it does the stuff doesn't need to be ready. So you can kind of make a decision based on what's on the board. If you can get good value out of it, great. It is a 4-power body. Just got to be a little careful about it. We got Shinkan, potential for a little steal there. Unity or Discord is a fun one. You can use a friendly non-Star Alliance creature or return up to two friendly creatures and each upgrade attached to them to their owner's hands. That's a good way to get a little more value out of the Hawkins for sure. Maybe a little more value out of the Stunner. That's really the only upgrade we have so far. Maybe you return something stunned to your hand, but or something damaged rather, but probably not. In the worst case scenario, we just use a creature. Oh, got two of those. Nice. All right, so let's see what we have in Unfathomable then. We start off with General Sherman. It's a 10-power beast that deals no damage when fighting, but when you play it, you purge each other creature. And I would just purge them under it, because when it leaves play, you return to play each creature purged this way. It goes exhausted and under its owner's control. Very interesting card. But, yeah, wow. Oh, Sobob's Thingamabob is an artifact with an amber. It says after your opponent forges a key, exhaust each creature they control. That's nice. Thalassophobia is an action with an amber, and it says play discard the top 10 cards of your opponent's deck. That can be a real combo breaker, and sometimes it can be, depending on if you have a little way to manipulate their deck at all, it can be even more interesting than that. But okay, Echo Pearl, great control, right? Exhaust, stun, and enrage a creature, so good. Wrath or Ruin is an action that says play, choose one, destroy a flank creature, or return two enemy creatures to their owner's hands. Yeah, these are nice effects, but this is just underwhelming compared to other cards in a similar vein, so bad feelings about that. Got another one of those, and this one has a capture icon on it. That's interesting. But I mean, solid control here. Ooh, we've got Brain Drain, which lets you look at your opponent's hand, choose a card, and put it on top of their deck. That's great. We've got a Frigorific Rod that actions to exhaust a creature or artifact. That's pretty strong. Guiltspine Netcaster has Reap, exhaust a creature, and it has a capture on it. It enhanced with two captures. So, are these the only source of the captures? I've seen two captures. Yeah, we've just seen the two, so that's probably it. We got a Hookmaster. That's nice. Way to let to make your opponent lose some amber. Rakuzel's Chant exhausts creatures. So we're gonna really be exhausting the enemy's creatures quite a lot. And then finally we have Wacolia, which has Reap, keys cost plus two during your opponent's next turn. That's something I haven't had work out very well often. Yeah, okay, so this deck seems fine. I think I don't love the Wrath or Ruin. There's a lot of amber floating around in the Unfathomable, or maybe that's just a lot of capture. But I do mostly like the Unfathomable setup here. It's hard. The Star Alliance setup, I like setups with more upgrades, but then we have that wipe clear too, so I'm not totally sad we don't have upgrades. But kind of an interesting trade-off there. Yeah, so that I'm gonna guess actually for this one, I'm gonna guess this one is about a 65. Like it has some amber generation, but just not convinced it's that much. And how's the board control though? So maybe I should say more like 68 for this one probably. Let's see. Oh wow, 61, definitely lower than I thought, especially because it has those nice board wipes. I figured those would count for something, but no. Yeah, zero efficiency. Yeah, that's fair. There's really not any speed going on here. You're just gonna play the cards in the order you got them. So that's that. That was Hero Lords Zip Hunt. Hope you enjoyed and that you'll get out and forge some keys.